Yeah, what up? Welcome back to another video, guys. So today, by the title, you already know what we're gonna be doing. It took me a while to really think about this and kind of sit down, hit the drawing boards, look at the bike, and figure out what I want to do with it, where we're gonna go from here, and where I kind of want to end up at with. So obviously from the beginning, I chose to get a Road Glide Special chromed out edition. I like the chrome better than the all blacked out version. Just because I had an all black bike, I had the all black Lowrider S. But now just looking at the bike, the way it sits and the where I kind of want to take it, I think it's time to black it out. Now, as of right now, I'm not gonna try to black everything out. It's only maybe like three components which I want to do, and that's gonna be the front forks right here. This will be all blacked out. The crash bar will be all blacked out, and well, that's basically it, because I'm gonna end up getting the black Santoro crash bars here, same crash bars that that Peanuts has on his bike. So it'll be the black Santoro bar with the black crash bar on the front, and then the forks in the front all blacked out as well. That's for right now. That's all I want to do. And then I'm gonna switch this air cleaner out here. I might keep that chrome. I'm not sure. For now, that's what I want. And also the top. I'm gonna order the dash right here all black as well, and I'm gonna leave the gas cap chrome. I don't know, something about it. I was looking at this picture of a knucklehead and another one of a shovelhead, and the way it was black and red with a few components blacked out like that, I'm like, you know what, that's how my bike needs to be. I just feel like the black forks in the front are just gonna, they're gonna make the bike just, I don't know, look better. And then just having the chrome in the middle, it'll still look really good, because we'll have the heart of everything right here. We'll have the Milwaukee 8 all chromed out with the pipes chromed out and everything else blacked out. So it's gonna flow really, really nice. Let's hop in the bike. Let's keep talking about what we're gonna be doing today, where I'm heading to right now, especially, and everything else. Woo. She sounds pretty. Now you must be asking yourself, why the hell didn't he just buy the all blacked out bike from the beginning? Well, I'll tell you right now, I really, really like the chrome. I looked at the bike in black, and then I looked at the bike chromed out the way I have it here, and there was something about it, it just attracted me to it. I mean, a black and red bike, a black and red Harley Davidson at that with chrome, it just screams nostalgic at that. I put them next to each other. It was the black one and this one. I just, you know what, I'm just gonna go with the all chrome. Now there is a local shop that's gonna be doing this work for me, so that's where I'm heading to right now. I'm gonna go talk to Mike. He's the owner of Torque Custom Cycles. No, not the other Torque. That's something else. This is an actual shop. So in this shop, they build bikes, they do powder coating, they have a dyno, a whole ton of stuff. So once we get to the shop, I'll try to give you guys a little walkthrough if it's possible, and I'll tell you a little bit more about the shop and what Mike does as well. But I'm gonna put up this little clip right here so you guys can see, because I did meet up with Mike 2 weeks back ago at Rutt's Hut for bike night. And he had his tent set up with two other bikes that they build from his shop. Just watch the clip. It's really, really, really cool what these guys are doing. All right, guys, so we're here at Rutt's Hut. Everyone's still setting up, so we're pretty early. So not a lot of bikes left here. But we're gonna show you a few other bikes that are already set up for the show tonight. We're here at the Torque Custom Cycles tent. Something very special I wanna show you guys. We're gonna go over a part, triple tree part, that has been in development for the past year or so, that they've been working on, the Triumph, something that is not available in the US. So you're the first company to make this available in the US?
Yeah, it's gonna be for sale within the next 6 to 8 months.
All right, awesome. So basically what we got here, we got the Triumph, Triumph Bobber?
So yeah, it's a 2022 Bobber, which has been customized to my liking, but we've developed the wide front end, which will now house a 180 tire on a 17 inch rim, and we could also do a 180 tire on the rear. We're running a 160 tire just because it's a little easier to maneuver around and ride the thing, but it does have room for a 180.
Nice. So let's just show everyone real quick the stock Triple Tree as opposed to this one. Up and down this way.
You heard it, right?
Yeah. All right, so here we got the stock Triple Tree, and this is the one that you've developed, right?
Yep.
So you did the Triple Tree, and what else have you done?
We extended it by 56 millimeters to make it wider, and we also had to make a wider axle then that would go in and house the wheel.
Now with that, can people still use stock brakes,
stock rotors, stock calipers? And we also have the stock headlight remounted in the original location, stock speedometer, original location. And these are actually aftermarket Wonderkind sleeves that still do fit in the original location.
Nice. This still looks sick, man.
Love the chase and the hunt, and I set the pace when I'm running. I always take what I want, and I always give it 100. Don't need a bank, no, I'm funded. Play the game like it's nothing. I'm always thankful for something. Don't take for granted, stay humble. Now wake up, it's time to look at the enemy. Look in the mirror if he is.
So what else on this bike is custom that I'm pretty sure people might ask for? Exhaust?
So the exhaust is custom. The tail section where the lights are under the seat. We've got a custom seat. We've powder coated Brembo brakes in Brembo red, powder coated and Cerakoted a lot of parts. We've got engine covers on there also by Motone on both sides, and handlebar risers are custom, grips, levers, mirrors.
And everything's built within your shop, right?
Yeah, everything's built in our shop.
I want to show you guys this nice bike right here that they built as well. They cut out the tank and just it looks super crazy. But they're going to be doing a lot of more customizations. So if you are in the local area, New Jersey, New York, check them out. I'm going to be linking up all the description down below in the description box. And anything else that your shop is going to be able to provide? I need to talk powder coating.
Yeah,
right?
So the new shop that we moved into now has a powder coating room. We've got a dyno. So we can do engine performance work, and we can dyno your bikes.
Powder coating and a dyno. Okay, good. Nice. And then you guys are also developing other stuff at the time you can talk about, or not yet?
I am in development. It's actually, we're supposed to go into production soon. This Triumph Bobber also has a secondary air induction system.
Okay.
Which pumps fresh air into the head for emissions, but we've got a block off plate that we're putting in there. We'll not throw a check engine light. We've got a whole kit coming out within probably the next 6 months, and the kits are going to be available from A&J Cycles and Canyon Motorcycles.
Nice.
And that's Canyon is also who we're teaming up with to do the wheel kits.
Okay. Show everybody what you've done with this bike over here real quick. This is what originally?
This was a 2003 Softail Springer Anniversary Edition. And this bike's been totally transformed.
If he is no friend to me, it's not working out. Maybe it's the chemistry. It's time to break up so I can make a better me. Better believe in your mind, cause it's everything. You can mold, shape, find almost anything. All it takes is some time and some clarity to find your identity. It's mind over everything.
So that's Mike, those are his bikes, that's what he does, and right now we're gonna head to his shop, we're gonna give you a little sneak peek at everything else, so tune in.
The chase and the hunt, and I set the pace when I'm running. I always take what I want, and I always give it 100. Don't need a bank, no, I'm funded. Play.
All right, guys, so we're here at the shop. This is a Torque Custom Cycle Shop. We've got a few bikes on the lift right here. We've got a dyno, so if you're in the area, you want to get your bike dyno, do some work to it,
and put a cam in, doing stage two, stage three, stage four. Gonna be doing it here. There's a powder coating room in the back as well. We're gonna go there, but it's back there. Also, if you wanna do some audio, you got all the audio equipment here, so bunch of cables and everything. So I wanna do that later on to my bike. Add some speakers onto the bags. So for you audio heads as well, you get that work done here. So ton of stuff. Powder coating, there's audio, there's dyno tuning, there's bike builds and everything up in here. So I'm gonna be linking up the description down below in the box. You guys can hit up Mike. And as well for you Triumph lovers, for that little clip that I posted up there, you definitely hit up Mike for that. Let him build your bike out and extend those front forks out to the front. Give that nice little oxy look.
All right, we are heading back home now. Gotta go back home and film a video with my main man Jerry, the coolest white guy I know. So tune in for that video as well. So yeah, guys, Mike is super, super nice guy, man. Super chill. Definitely tune in for more content. He might be doing a lot more work on my bike pretty soon. I don't want to spoil it. Yeah, the plan is going to be to get that work done on the bike first within the next few weeks. And then in the next month, I'm going to get everything powder coated, the stuff that I want. I got to order my black Santoro crash bar, so the back as well. So while I order the crash bar, I'll get the work done and disassemble and put everything together. There's also something else coming in for the bike in 2 weeks, which I'm really, really excited about. I am getting a brand new seat for the bike. It's Lucky Dave's seat. It's nice, but I wanted something nicer. I wanted something that was customized, you know, with my ideas and how I want it to look exactly. And something more of quality at that as well. So definitely tune in for that. There's a lot of Road Glide content. Jesus. Anyways, that's going to be it. I'm going to catch you guys on the next one. Like always, let the force be with you. Ride safe and enjoy the ride, baby. Peace. Sergio, what did you do?
Yeah, Sergio.
Why are you getting so mad, dude?
Why are you throwing shit? This guy's a fucking screw.
I want a wiener.
Hey.
Wait. Jerry, watch out, Jerry.
Homerangs.
Jerry, he wants your wiener, he said.
What?
He wants your wiener.
Dark meat only.
Whoa.
little.
I don't know what the fuck you guys are up to at Bergen Harley, but hopefully it's just Sergio.
You don't like dark turkey? So you hang out with your boys. I'm gonna make a deep.